Fat Bobbo.
Banjo, Sid and Fred all say simultaneously, then laugh. It is the only moment there has been humour for some time when talking about the war. Although the war is no laughing matter, and they all know it. Mary doesn't take the paper to Hiroshi. She knows that this kind of thing will only cause him grief. His mental stability is already questionable. She knows he feels guilt and regret and longs to be with his family, if not on the war front. She wants to take his mind away from the misery that causes the grief, even if momentarily. What are you doing? Mrs. Smith asks Mary as she catches her flicking through a book from the shelves she should be dusting. Mary has to think quickly because she doesn't want to get into trouble and be summoned to the manager. I would like to read some poetry, she says cautiously. Since I left school, I have nothing to read, just the newspaper, and that's nearly always depressing, which isn't a lie. You mention you love the man who wrote The Jungle Book? She says, thinking on her feet. Yes, dear, but this is also a very, very good collection you could read. Mrs. Smith takes the volume from Mary and runs her fingers over the title, The Man from Snowy River and Other Verses. A. B. Patterson has written the finest poems you are likely to read, right here. She waves the book in front of the girl. Mary listens, grateful for not being caught red-handed in the throes of theft, but she is also interested in knowing more about the poet so she can share it with Hiroshi. Do you have a favourite poem? Mary asks, impressed with her newfound ability to think and lie on the spot. Or is there a popular poem that I should focus on? There are two very famous poems, Mrs. Smith says, flicking through the volume looking for them. Mr. Smith occasionally recites them after dinner. One is obviously The Man from Snowy River, and the other is called Clancy of the Overflow.